Two people were killed after an improvised explosive device went off in Masbate Sunday morning. The victims were Malaya FC and former Far Eastern University football player Keith Absalon and his cousin. Absalon's 16-year-old nephew also suffered injuries. The victims were riding their bikes when they were hit by shrapnel. Authorities believe the IED was planted by the New People's Army.
The Philippine Energy Department warns the Luzon grid may again be placed under red alert this week. The DOE says while power supply is sufficient, reserves in the country's major grid remain thin. It adds red alert conditions may remain until June 10th, and yellow alert may still be raised in the coming weeks. A red alert means rotational power outages similar to last week may happen.
Local hog raisers oppose a proposal to immediately import some 110,000 metric tons of pork. The Philippines recently increased the minimum access volume of pork in a bid to augment supply and lower the prices of meat products. Industry players have agreed to import 200,000 metric tons of pork gradually over a one-year period. But the Agriculture Department has recommended to import half of that number between the July and September period to stabilize supply. Several groups are questioning the proposal.
Hindi, dahil na gusto nilang padamihin ang supply sa Persa 3 months. Dahil kung sa tingin nila ay kulang pa at ina-absorb yung in-import nila base doon sa 16,000 per month na 16,600 metric tons per month at kulang, wala naman limit para sila mag-import doon sa outside MAB. Na ang diferensya lang naman, 20% ang tarif instead na 10%.
The Philippines has started exporting okra to South Korea. This comes 9 months after the country started shipping okra to Japan. Agriculture and trade officials hope this will pave the way for more high-value crops grown in the Philippines to reach other countries.
Ang negosasyon started 10 years ago, so it took 10 years before this first commercial shipment is done. This will really strengthen our efforts to really support the high-value crops, not only for local consumption, but for exports.
Ngayon po, ang taripa ng okra going into Korea ay mga nasa 27%. So amin pong ninenegotiate na gawin itong 0%. Pag mas mababang tarif sa Korea, mas magandang access natin at mas makaka-export tayo ng mas madami.